We're going to do a song. This song is called Poor. This is for anybody who sometimes feels that they're not enough of an overachiever. If you don't get the reference, SW3 is a postcode in London. It's Chelsea. It's where all the bankers and hedge fund managers used to live. Now they're being forced out by Russian oligarchs. I want to be in SW3, living the high life with my wife. Shopping till we're dropping and then stopping for some cocktails with friends. So much cash in the bank that they personally thank me. The manager offers to wank me and showers me with letters and the statements and the Christmas cards he sends. My wife is pretty, I work in the city, drink highballs while coked to the eyeballs, gurning while I'm earning pots of money which I spend to have a laugh, flashing my cash with my credited cronies, snuffling like truffling man pigs. In some Gordon Ramsay gaffer we get wankered and start feeling up the stuff. Drinking wine we can no longer smell, we will put that poor waitress through hell. Wouldn't that life just be swell for me? Except my wife has never loved me and she only married me upon her sister's advice. Reluctantly she lets me fuck her twice a year, not in the rear, it's dear at half the price. She has a handbag the size of a compact car, wears face cream that comes in a diamond jar. She does bugger all but says she's in PR. My so-called friends despise me cause they like to think their bonuses are bigger than mine. They snigger when I say that sometimes clouds to me look just like dragons. I work 12 hours a day, but it gets me nowhere. I cry in the gents and I'm losing my hair. My friends are all pricks and my wife is a whore. Frankly, I'd rather be poor. I want to be like that guy Wayne Rooney, no looker but totally loaded. Gosh, he has the dosh to pay a pensioner to nosh him on the sly.
Sucky sucks out.
Well, he might read the Mail and he might read the Sun now. The news of the world has imploded, but he won't look in the mirror, and with looks like that it's easy to see why. I want to be like a young British artist, duping the rubes at the White Cube, exhibiting some bollocks even Jackson Pollock would call badly made. Brian Sewell hates me, but Charles Saatchi rates me and buys my entire collection. If only cause he knows I'll overdose and earn him double what he paid. Living somewhere the laws are quite lax, well I don't see why I should pay tax. All my friends at Goldman Sachs agree. Except I can kick a ball around and earn £100 million, but I can't go to Waitrose. My private life gets splashed around like pure Lambrini. It's a scene that makes me hate those stupid twats with the long lens and no sense of shame, who seem to think somehow my sex life's fair game. I guess I'm the one who must take all the blame, or take the credit for some painting that my underpaid assistant actually did. I can see the dollar signs, but I no longer see the dragons. I spend my life in some god-awful members club, when really I'd much rather go down the pub. I hang out with Bono. Oh no, what a bore. Frankly, I'd rather be poor. I'd like to be someone mostly like me, perhaps with a small dog for company. Even though I'm overdrawn and live in Southern England's smallest flat,
it's full of rats.
It's a humble address, but it's free of the stress that curses the people of Chelsea and makes them flip their lids and take a shotgun to the next door neighbor's cat. Well, it won't come as much of a shock if my jewelry all goes into hock. Still, at least I won't suck Satan's cock.
What, too much?
It's just not true.
Wealth can be a chore. The Cotswolds are a snore, but I want just a little more. For me, for me, for me.
Thank you very much.